There are multiple packages in Next.js that we can use in order to send emails. One of the good packages that I've been working on is Resend. It has a good documentation and it's easy to use and great to use for React and Next.js environments. This is its website and you can sign in and register here. I've already done that. In order to send multiple emails, we call it batch emails, you need to register your domains. I've already done that, so I can do it again. When you click on add domain button, it will give you multiple DNSs that you have to put it in your domain name servers settings. For example, if I'm hosting my domain in Vercel, I have to come in here to the Vercel.com website and click on domains tab. View details for my already registered domain. And in this section, DNS records, you have to put the types, exact types, and the exact name with the value and the priority and the title live for it. You can use this comment section in order to be descriptive about what you're doing and add it to your domain settings. When you do that, after a few minutes or hours, it took me about 7 minutes, your domain has been verified. Then you can come in here and get your API keys. When you get your API keys in here, you can copy it in your project in your env file. Remember that this file is not supposed to be exposed. Right now, I've pasted my API key into my env file. So, how can we send an email using Next.js? In order to do that, let's create a route called api/sendemail. In the route.ts file, I want to export async function post. Okay, first we need to test this route. I'm going to return a response with next response. JSON message email sent successfully. We haven't done anything yet, but we're just gonna test this route first. For my own request client, I use this app HTTP. Let's start the server. Still waiting. Okay. Localhost 3000 API send email, and this is a post request. Now let's send it. When we send that email sent successfully, its response is okay. But we wanna use a package called Resend. In emails tab, we can see this button open API references. So in order to send an email, we have to download this package, import a Resend instance, make a new instance of the Resend, and email using this syntax. I'm gonna copy this and paste it in here. This belongs to this function. Let me minimize this. We need to install PNI Resend. This is the same syntax as npm install Resend. I'm using PNPM. I'll make another video out of it. For here, I have to paste my API key process.env Resend API key. From this section, onboarding @resend.dev, I have to put up my exact domain that I have verified on Resend. For me, it's mora-ed.com. info@mora-ed.com. From mora deliver to, I'm gonna just put my email in here. Subject, hello world from Resend. And the HTML is paragraph containing it works. And I wanna return something, get something, data. Data contains of the response of this function. It might be an error or the data ID. it gives me an email ID. So I wanna respond with email ID in here, data.data.id. Let's put it in catch block, try return next response error that message. No, I'm gonna send the error itself. Yep. Seems good. Let's check it out. Email sent successfully. The ID is this. And let's check our emails. And as you can see here, it works perfectly. Let's head this further by taking destination email address from the user using next request. Next request. And then let's create a template, email template for that. For the first step, I'm just gonna body weight request.json. I'm gonna decouple that and get an email and the first name. Email, address, and the name from body. And in here, I wanna send that email, hello, and I'm gonna put name in here. Sounds good. And if any of email or name does not exist, I wanna return email or name is missing with the status code of 400. Seems good. Let's add a status code of 500. If we got an error, seems good. Let's check our API route. Email not sent. Why? Because we must have gotten because we did not send email or name. For body text JSON email. Oh, I'm sorry, I must have magnified this window for you. I want to send an email to my own email. Name is Reza. Email sent successfully and did the ID of this. Let's check our emails. Hello Reza from Resend. That's amazing. It works perfectly. And for the last step, I want to create a template for that. So in here, in my React application, whether you have a component folder, component directory, or whatever, I'm gonna just create a simple email template file, tsx. And I'm gonna take params, type params, take email, which is a type of string, and the name, which is also a type of string. Email and name. Email template. No, for the title, I want it to be hi. The name of the person that I want to send it to with an hand wave emoji in here. For the welcome to the Resend Club. This is a test for YouTube video. Smiley face emoji. This is not working. This should be working. Oh, this one's better. Just gonna hit save. And in here, I wanna use React instead of email. Template, gonna import this and send these two parameters to it. Now let's check our API again. Email has been sent successfully. Oh, look at that. Hi Reza, welcome to the Resend Club. This is a test for YouTube video. And with that, our video is gone. So in this video, we have verified our domain in Resend, created our own API keys, and use the documentation to send emails. You can use this package to send multiple batch emails or manage your emails as a developer. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. Oh, stay active. Bye-bye.